Oh, what's that we hear? We'll figure this out. Who needs to help? It's just boom, boom, boom.
This opera is like no other opera I've ever directed before, because all of the action, in a way, has taken place before the opera even begins.
There's all sorts of murky text explaining what's going on in the story, so when we see you guys, it's like, ah, once upon a time. Okay, let's give this a rumble.
Jacopo has been framed for a murder, but he's getting nowhere, and his father, the Doge, is caught between a rock and a hard place because he is the representative of law in Venice. But he's a father also.
It is a part that I am too young to do it because the character is supposed to be 89. So that's very, very amusing because, of course, today, any character that I do, they are younger than my age, you know.
L'accusa è l'omicidio, ma il vero motivo è minare l'integrità e la come si dice, la purezza della famiglia del Doge.
In quest'opera Lucrezia è la vera, secondo me, il vero motore di tutta la vicenda. Lei che si batte e lei che va dal padre di suo marito a chiedere che venga perdonato, a chiedere che intervenga a favore di suo figlio, a favore del proprio marito, e affinché i figli abbiano di nuovo un padre.
Lei lotta in maniera estenuante per proteggere il marito e lui subisce tutto quello che gli succede senza opporsi più di tanto.
E Verdi la mette a nudo quasi davanti al pubblico, perché veramente le fa esprimere tutte le proprie capacità.
There's a cracking duet between the Doge and his daughter-in-law. She pleads in a very, very dynamic manner for him to intercede. This exchange of phrases are one of the highlights of this piece.
The relation of the Doge and the Lucrezia is tremendous, you know, with the daughter-in-law, which is no very often that connection in an opera.
The waves get going right before he sings.
There's also capturing the color of Venice.
The thing, so I can see it, yeah.
Throughout the piece, we will have this feeling of three or six, for instance, bloom, bloom.